Hi folks, welcome to the ultimate camo painting. What you're looking at now is a test that I did yesterday. It was the first time I ever really tried to paint camo with plants and other items. It's just a test, just to see what I could come up with. Some of it looks really good, some of it doesn't look so good. You can see down here, tried a couple of different nets as a, you know, as a stencil. You can see some of the effects of it. It didn't turn out so well, but some of it did. This real fine veiny looking stuff, I'll show you what that is here soon. You can see I tried some of the octagon or six-sided cuts there. This is what I like though, right in there. That section looks really good. So what I've done is, like I said yesterday, I went out and picked some plants, tried some tests and stuff, tried to come up with what I liked. I think I did. At that point, I took those plants and I stacked them underneath things like that, okay, and left them there overnight so they would lay flat, okay. The first item up here is a piece of landing net. You're wondering what those little veins were. It's the landing net. Okay, let's see how cool that looks. I think this was probably the best idea I came up with on the whole thing. Okay, so nice and flat. And then under here, I have some more. Nice and flat. There you go, that's better. Okay, I'll stack all that right on top of everything. Got some more. Nice and flat. Wanted some bigger leaves. Two. So I went and got a little bit of vine. Oh, the wind's gonna mess me all up now. Couple of weeds. This is the one that turned out so well that I like really a lot. And then there's a couple pieces of grass in there. I don't know how well that's going to work. I didn't really try that, but what the hell. Okay, so I've got all my leaves. I've got them all nice and flat. Makes it easier. And I got a couple of small ones up here. There you go. Alright, so I got my leaves, I got my net. Almost time to paint. Okay, there's the boat. I've already put one coat of the green paint on it. I'm gonna put another coat on it. The thing to remember here is that the color that you choose to use your base coat, that's the color your leaves are gonna be. Okay? I'm painting this just because I'm a hunter and I like camo patterns. A lot of guys will want to paint it for duck hunting though, okay? I wouldn't do a green for duck hunting. I would do more like a tan because you want to replicate those leaves on the cattails and the dry, you know, the swamps and all that. And I think a tan leafy pattern would be better, like a long leaf. You know, go get some cattails, you know, use that, okay? But this is only one coat. And you can see it hides a lot of the defects really well. To be honest with you, this boat's pretty beat up. That's really why I'm doing this, because I'm just trying to hide some of the dents and the bends and the bruises and everything else. So, but that's one coat. I'll do it again after the second coat, see if you can see a difference. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to create a pattern like that, okay? Once we're done, this whole boat will be covered in camo, something like that. One thing I saw a lot of guys do when they were doing their videos was taking their leaf and just laying it down there and spraying it. Okay? That's cool and all, but a lot of today's modern camo has like a shadow effect built into it. You know, it'll be a log going across the camo pattern, and you'll see the shadow of the log behind.
And I started thinking about that.
I wanted to try out a way to create that. So what you do, instead of moving it after you paint sprayed it once, removing it, I should say, just take it and move it over a little bit. Take white. And boom. You get a shadow effect.
Okay. That's a little harsh, I'm thinking.
Just a tad on the harsh side. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to break that up a little bit. Remember earlier I mentioned that net that I had? I'm going to use this. I'm going to do this one in black. Just going to throw that net across there. Boom. Breaks it up big time. Gives it that 3D effect.
Kind of gives you a little weeds.
Okay.
Move.
You got a spot you don't like. Take something else. Make your white. Boom. Boom. Just give it a little bit of shadow. Okay.
Now, I'm going to do that again. I'm going to try this leafy pattern though. It's fine.
Let's always start with black. Okay. Okay. Move it over a little bit. Just a tad. And then pick up the white. Boom. Got a shadow effect. So now I got those big empty spaces. Well, guess what? Do a little buying, you know. Kind of cover it up. That places in between, give it more of a just like that. Not like that, you always go back. There you go. We're going to do the whole tilt just like that. The other thing I'm finding is making it go a little faster actually. Did you see how I've used the big leaf patterns and just laid them down with some black? Right? Well, I'm going to take some of the smaller leaf patterns and kind of cover those up. Kind of cover them up with the white and the red. And then go over it with the net too. Yeah, that way you don't have to keep switching leaves back and forth, back and forth. You can throw down a couple, you know, there's two different patterns there. You can see them right there. You can see the leafy stuff here, and then this long leafy stuff there, the rounder leaves. Okay, now you just saw just the black, the heavy black, okay, with the big leaf stuff. Now I went back through and with the white, some red, and even a little bit more black. You can see I filled all those little voids and added detail to it by using those real fine stuff. But you see, it really makes it snap, don't it? I'm loving that red. I'm loving those, that landing net pattern. Don't be afraid to cover up stuff. You can see that I started this with the grass pattern, okay, and then I put, well, whatever it was over the top of it, but you see there's some landing net there, There's some more of that little stuff. You see, it's really just a blend, you know, and if you don't like what's there, pick up your black, spray it over, do it again. Okay, so I've pretty much done this side of the boat. You can see, like right there, you see where I sprayed it once with black, moved it over, and then sprayed it with white. You can see this little line right there. Okay, I think that really adds a lot of dimension to it. I'm really, really liking this netting, this pattern here. Okay, if you can find yourself an old net, flash it, smash it flat, and use that, it really adds a lot of dimension to it, a lot of like veins and stuff to it. But you can see, it's a little repetitive sometimes. But overall, I'm very happy. I think it looks outstanding. I'm loving it. It's gonna look good when she's done, that's for sure. Alright, here's the finished product. There's the boat as it is done. One thing I did find after using that layered pattern, I did go back with some black just to give it more black, because it was turning, the blacks were turning into gray. You see one spot down there that's really black, that little spot. There's another one right there. Just to snap it up, I guess. Snap it up a little bit, you know. But that's the finished boat. I did do one side of this in clear coat and the other side not. You can tell the side on the right has got the clear coat in it. I don't like it. It makes the lines too defined. It doesn't give it that blurred, fuzzy look when you clear coat it. So I'll probably finish up doing the back of that, but I'm not going to do the rest of the boat. You can see this side is a little bit heavier than the other side. But hey, you know, you only look at one side at a time. All right, there it is, finished.